Eric still couldn't find work, had to borrow money from friends to survive. With eviction almost a certainty, Eric took advantage of his situation to live out a lifelong dream. He packed up his belongings, stored them in his parents' empty cabin in Williams, Arizona, and returned the U-Haul truck to Flagstaff. And with nothing holding him down anymore, Eric became a hobo.
When a woman gets the blues, she hangs her little head and cries. But when a man gets the blues, he grabs a train and rides.
As a lifelong train enthusiast, Eric loved riding the rails. He found the fresh air, pine trees, and open spaces of northern Arizona rejuvenating. Eric wrote in his travel journal, "I ain't never seen no land more beautifuler than the great pine forests of America. But I haven't traveled much." The freedom of hobo life cleared his head. Without easy access to dairy products, his milkaholism was cured. To feel more connected with the universe, he would step out of his tent and let the morning breeze and sun wash over his naked body before getting dressed and moving on. But the euphoria of hobo freedom didn't last long. After about a week of washing up in public restrooms, walking miles a day, and trying to sleep on loud, rocking boxcars, hobo reality caught up with him. Eric's plan was to start hopping boxcars in Flagstaff, head west to L.A., and then make his way north to Portland, Oregon, where he'd stay with his friend Karen Suk and get a little something-something from another friend. But on March 29th, halfway through his journey, as expected, Eric wussed out.
The Eric Paul Johnson Radio Trolla program airs Friday nights at 9 o'clock Arizona time. And listen anytime at radiotrollup.com.